So we're talking about density. Density is mass within a certain amount of volume. Our formula is mass divided by volume. The proper units that you'll notice for density are grams per centimeter cubed or grams per milliliter. Let's jump into our first example that uses density as a conversion factor. What is the mass of 25.0 milliliters of octane with a density of 0.702 grams per cubic centimeter? As always, start with identifying your given conversion factor or factors and what you are finding. The given is 25.0 milliliters. Your conversion factors: 1 milliliter is equal to 1 cubic centimeter. Then we'll use this to get to grams using the density as our second conversion factor. So 1 cubic centimeter is equal to 0.702 grams. Lastly, we are finding mass. Mass, if it's not otherwise stated, is measured in grams. The plan is going from our given unit, milliliters, then using our first conversion factor to go to cubic centimeters. Lastly, we'll use our density as our second conversion factor to get to grams. Our proper setup, placing our given in the beginning as always, 25.0 milliliters. Align the milliliters across from each other so they can cancel out. Next, we'll use our first conversion factor and we'll get to cubic centimeters. Align those units once again so they can cancel out. And finally, placing our density at the very, very end, so we'll get our unit that we're looking for, which is grams. Multiply straight across and really divide by one. You get 17.55 grams. However, we have three sig figs since our given was 1, 2, 3 significant figures. We'll round this 5 on up, and our final answer is 17.6 grams. Let's incorporate density and dimensional analysis. The density of titanium is 4.51 grams per cubic centimeter. What is the volume in cubic inches of 3.5 pounds of titanium? Start with identifying your given and your conversion factors, since there are multiple in this question, and what you are finding. The given is 3.5 pounds, and our conversion factors, we actually have four in this case, to get from pounds to eventually grams, we'll go from pounds to kilograms. Next, we'll use kilograms to get to grams using the metric system. Our third conversion factor is the density, which was provided, which is 4.51 grams for every 1 cubic centimeter. Next, we want to get to inches, so we'll use our last conversion factor, 2.54 centimeters, to get to 1 inch, and we are solving for inches cubed. As we saw before, we have four conversion factors. Our plan is starting with our given unit, which is in pounds, using our first conversion factor to get to kilograms. Then we'll use our second conversion factor to get to grams, our third conversion factor, which was density, to get to cubic centimeters. And lastly, we'll use our fourth conversion factor to get to inches. And we'll see that we will have to cube at the very end. Our given is what we start with, 3.5 pounds, aligning those pounds across from each other so they can then cancel. And let's do this together. So our pounds cancel out. On top is our kilograms. Once again, we'll align kilograms across from each other. So those kilograms also cancel out. We're now to our third conversion factor, and we'll align the grams across from one another so they can cancel. We see the pattern. But we see that this is not cubed, so we cannot cancel these two out. This entire conversion factor then has to be cubed. Once we do this, we will cube that 2.54 and we'll get centimeters cubed as well. And 1 cubed is actually just 1, but our inches cubed will now be there as well. Let's cancel all the different units. So our pounds cancel, kilograms, grams, and cubic centimeters finally cancel, leaving us with the unit that we were finding all along, cubic inches. Multiply straight across and divide by 2.2, 4.51, and 16.387, all multiplied. you get 2.53 cubic inches. However, our given was only 2 sig figs, so we'll go ahead and round up. Our final answer is 22 cubic inches. Let's calculate density. Calculate the density in grams per milliliter of aluminum with a volume of 0.6 cubic centimeter and a mass of 4.6 milligrams. You're gonna have two different givens. We have the 4.6 milligrams and 0.6 cubic centimeters. Since we are solving for density, we have a formula for that. Our mass divided by our volume, but specifically we want the unit to be grams per milliliter. Step one is taking our milligrams and converting them to grams. Our given was 4.6 milligrams, always aligning the milligrams across from one another so they can then cancel. Milligrams cancel, we now are left with 4.6 times 10 to the negative third grams. Step two, we'll take our cubic centimeters and convert them to milliliters. That 0.6 cubic centimeters then gets aligned with our conversion factor of 1 cubic centimeter to 1 milliliter. Cubic centimeters cancel. Multiply straight across, we'll get 0.6 milliliters. And our last step is just to divide our grams divided by our milliliters. So step one divided by step two, we'll end up getting grams per milliliter.
Okay, here's a pen. Now try these practice problems. How'd you do? Do you feel like you need some more practice? If so, check the description box below. There's a link with practice problems and step-by-step answers. And remember to like this video if you learned something, and subscribe if you want to see more videos just like this one. And remember, I am here to help you pass chemistry. So leave a comment below letting me know what you need help with, and I'll see you next time.